بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. وبعد، Indeed أيها الإخوة، الله سبحانه وتعالى is informed us in his kitab ولله الأسماء الحسنى فادعوه بها وذروا الذين يلحدون في أسمائه. Allah mentions that to Allah Azza wa Jal belongs the most beautiful names and attributes. Or belongs the most beautiful names. فَدْعُوهُ بِهَا And so call upon him by way of them. And leave alone those who يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِ Those who enter into heresy and deviation as it relates to the names of Allah Azza wa Jal, for Allah Azza wa Jal will surely recompense them for what they do. And so our scholars have mentioned that from our belief in the asma'i wa sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is that we believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we call upon Allah Azza wa Jal based upon and using the names that Allah has informed us of concerning himself. And from the fiqh and the understanding of the Muslim as it relates to his supplication is that when he supplicates using the name that is most relative to his request. And so if, for example, he seeks forgiveness, then he says, Ya al-Ghafoor, Ya al-Rahman, Ya al-Rahim, Irhamni, Oh al-Ghafoor, Oh Yudi, After forgiving, oh, the most merciful, forgive me. If it is that he seeks from the bounties of Allah Azza wa Jal, then he says, Ya al-Wahhab, oh, you bestower of bounties, Ya al-Razaq, Ruzuqni, oh, bestower of bounties, oh, you who grants sustenance, grant me sustenance. And so it befits that the student of knowledge and that the Muslim generally is acquainted with the meanings of the names and the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he may call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based upon those names and attributes. And indeed, from the beautiful names of Allah Azza wa Jal is that Allah Azza wa Jal has referred to himself as At-Tawwab. Allah Azza wa Jal is At-Tawwab. And At-Tawwab, having the same origin as the word tawbah or repentance. As it relates to the name of Allah Azza wa Jal, At-Tawwab, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is At-Tawwab, as our scholars mentioned, Al-Shaykh Abdurrahman bin Nasir al-Sa'di, among them. He mentions that indeed, and likewise Al-Imam ibn al-Qayyim, that At-Tawwab, from its meanings, there are two main meanings that stand out. Number one, that Allah Azza wa Jal inspires his servant with tawbah. And number two, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts that tawbah from his servant when he makes tawbah and when he makes repentance. And so it, indeed, Allah Azza wa Jal is kind. And Allah Azza wa Jal, from his mercy, is that he instills the desire to make tawbah. He instills the regret in the heart of his servant that he may make tawbah. And then when he makes tawbah, he forgives him. As occurred with Ka'b ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, when he stayed away from the battle of Tabuk, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, upon his return, he was commanded to make hijrah and to make the hajar and to boycott him. And he did so for somewhere in the region of 50 days. And then Allah Azza wa Jal declared that he had accepted his tawbah and that they were maghfoor, or that they were forgiven, him and some three companions altogether. But Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned from the verse, ثُمَّ تَابَ عَلَيْهِمْ لِيَتُوبُوا Then Allah turned to them that they may make tawbah. Then Allah turned to them that they may make tawbah. So Allah Azza wa Jalla blessed them with tawbah by first turning towards them and inspiring them with tawbah, inspiring them with feeling regretful for what they have done, with feeling remorse over what had passed from their previous way. And so they made tawbah to Allah Azza wa Jalla, and eventually that tawbah was accepted, and the hajar or the boycotting of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam for that period was a lesson for the ummah to study and to learn from. And that there are certain actions, that type of action and that type of treatment is legislated for indeed it has the greatest effect upon the person who is boycotted. And that happened with Ka'b ibn Malik. The Messenger of Allah boycotted him to the extent that Ka'b ibn Malik, he mentioned that, "Wallahi, I would enter the masjid and I would give the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam salam, and by Allah, I do not know if his lips moved with response." And so that occurred, and then Allah Azza wa Jal accepted from them their tawbah. So from the names of Allah Azza wa Jal, At-Tawwab, the meaning of the name is that Allah Azza wa Jal inspires his servant with tawbah and then accepts that tawbah from him when he makes it. And so when we look at the affair of Salafiyya and the path that Allah Azza wa Jal has blessed us to be upon, we see that we have a number of different manifestations of people who take Salafiyya on board. From them, we have the individual who was born into Salafiyya. He was born Salafi from his first day. From the time that Allah Azza wa Jal blessed him to be upon earth and with life, he was Salafi. His parents were Salafi and nurtured him upon Salafiyya. And that, without doubt, is a great blessing. Then from them are those who enter Islam. Now, they were kuffar, first and foremost. And they enter Islam and they enter upon Salafiyya. And again, that is a great ni'mah and a great blessing that Allah Azza wa Jal takes them from darkness into light and into the most pure, pristine, bright light that they could possibly have taken on board, the light of the path of the Salaf of this Ummah. And then from the Muslimun are those who were upon a way other than the way of Salafiyya, and Allah Azza wa Jal blessed them to make tawbah from it. And those individuals, again, must thank Allah Azza wa Jal for this great blessing. And the one who deals with and comes across such an individual, he should exercise care and caution with such individuals. Allah Azza wa Jal mentioned, كَذَٰلِكَ كُنْتُم مِّن قَبْلِ فَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ. That is how you were once upon a time, and Allah blessed you. And so the mas'ala and the affair then of التَّائِبُ مِنَ الْبِدْعَةِ, or the one who makes repentance from innovation, our scholars mention that while it is a great blessing, there are some important fundamental principles related to their tawbah and to the acceptance of their tawbah and to their state after that tawbah. Allah Azza wa Jal mentions, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ مَا أَنزَلْنَا مِنَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَالْهُدَى مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا بَيَّنَّاهُ لِلنَّاسِ فِي الْكِتَابِ أُولَٰئِكَ يَلْعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَلْعَنَهُمُ اللَّاعِنُونَ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا وَبَيَّنُوا فَأُولَٰئِكَ أَتُوبَ عَلَيْهِمْ وَأَنَا التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Allah mentions, indeed those who hide that which is present in the book, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ مَا أَنزَلْنَا, that which we have revealed from the book, and from the clarification, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَكْتُبُونَ مَا أَنزَلْنَا مِنَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ وَالْهُدَى, after, and the guidance, after we have shown it to the people, maybe they hide it, or they change it, they distort its meanings, أُولَٰئِكَ يَلْعَنَهُمُ اللَّهِ, these are individuals who Allah curses, وَيَلْعَنَهُمُ اللَّاعِنُونَ, they are cursed by anyone who curses. Then Allah Azza wa Jalla mentions, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا وَبَيَّنُوا أَفْوَنْ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا وَبَيَّنُوا. Allah mentions at the end of the verse, except these are the three conditions that the scholars mention. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا وَبَيَّنُوا. Except those who make tawbah and they rectify and they clarify. Then these, Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned, these are the ones that I shall turn to. وَأَنَا التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. And I am a tawwab. We'll discuss something about the name a tawwab, al-Rahim, the mercy giver. So Allah Azza wa Jalla lays down some conditions for the one who makes tawbah from being upon a way that was erroneous, from being upon a way that opposed the way and the path of the Kitab and the Sunnah. Allah mentioned, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا, first and foremost. As far as the statement of Allah, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا, except those who make tawbah, then that is a reference to them establishing and turning to Allah Azza wa Jal and making tawbah in relation to that which is between themselves and Allah Azza wa Jal. And that is that they turn to Allah Azza wa Jal, asking Allah to forgive them, asking Allah to overlook their fault, to overlook their error, asking Allah Azza wa Jal to pardon them. That, ikhwan, is the first of the conditions. That they look towards their relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal and they ask Allah to forgive them for the shortcomings that occurred when they were upon that path. And so that is the first condition. Tawbah between them and Allah. The second condition is that Ahlul Ilm and our scholars, they mention, based upon the same verse in Surah Al-Baqarah, that Allah Azza wa Jal, He mentions, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا. Those who make tawbah, and secondly, أَصْلَحُوا. That is, that they rectify. What our scholars mention is that this affair of islah and rectification revolves around that individual. First and foremost, after making tawbah, he then addresses the errors that he has made. And if he made errors publicly, then he rectifies them publicly in a similar gathering. If he wrote a book that has innovation and what have you, and errors, then he writes a similar book correcting those errors and highlighting to the people that I was wrong and I used to believe and I used to say. If he did a lecture that is recorded, then he does a similar lecture in a similar gathering, rectifying his mistake. If it is, for example, that he addressed a gathering of individuals concerning this bid'ah, then he corrects what he was erroneous in terms of what he had said to them and what he used to promote. And so that rectification then is done in terms of what and where he went wrong, and where he erred, he rectifies it. And he removes and alleviates himself of the excuse of the erroneous path that he may have contributed in spreading. وَبَيَّنُوا. The third condition is al-bayan. That is, that he clarifies. And this bayan is the third condition related to his tawbah being accepted. And that is that Allah Azza wa Jal, after laying down the condition of him first making tawbah, asking Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive him, the second issue is, as we mentioned, that he rectifies any errors or any mistakes or any corruption that he may have caused. And then the third condition is that he clarifies. He clarifies his error. He makes that clear. And he makes that public. If it is that his errors did not reached the public arena, then there is no need for him to clarify, except that he clarifies to those who knew that he was upon a deviant way, that I used to be upon a particular way, but alhamdulillah, now Allah Azza wa Jalla has guided me. But as far as him having to make a public announcement, then that is not the case and not necessary for a person whose statement did not go public. But the one whose statements went public, then his retraction should be public. And that is why when Imam Abu al-Hasan al-Ash'ari, when he made Tawbah, he stood up upon the minbar, understanding this verse, because even when he was upon Bid'ah, he was an Imam in his own right. He was a person of knowledge who was upon error. And so he stood up upon the minbar, and he said that, verily I retract from my old statement and from my old positions, the way I removed this overgarment and this cloak of mine. And he took his cloak off and he threw it on the ground. And so he said, I retract my old statement the way I take and remove this garment. And so he made it public, and it was a public announcement that he had retracted from his old statement and from his old position. And so the path of Salafi, alhamdulillah, is spreading, ikhwan, just as we see Islam spreading. But let us strive, number one, to be from those who convey it correctly and make it easy for the people to accept. And number two, let us ensure that our living and our dying and our speaking, our remaining silent, that all of that revolves around this blessed, most noble path, particularly while we're here in the month of Ramadan. And on this, the 27th night of Ramadan, and we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to increase us in the knowledge of this way, to increase us in that which is present within it from khair, and that which is present within it from the extension and the completion of the path of the prophets and the messengers. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يوفقنا وإياكم لما يحبه ويرضاه. صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد.